You see this carving, this is a Anunnaki carving of Enki giving the pine cone of knowledge, which represents the pineal gland, which has that shape. But not only on this, but the same carvings like have been found in the cave of Tayos, the Tayos cave in Ecuador. And the Mayans, they had the same thing, same carving and the same little purse and the two watches, wrist watches, which are not wrist watches, it's something else. Might be a teleporter, who knows. That bracelet that was, that guy that Dr. Jonathan Ree caught was a bracelet, a teleportation device. Anyway, because nobody believed in any of that, but then we had this deal here. Now I'm gonna show you that this might have been, is found on the moon. There is a picture of Apollo 17, which I saw the first time. I couldn't understand what really was until I enlarged the image. And it was posted by this dude, alien hunter. But this guy doesn't know a damn thing about anything. He keeps saying aliens and alien cities and blah, blah, blah on the moon. I keep telling him there is no any of that. It's only sculptures. The entire moon is filled to the rim with sculptures. And those sculptures show something like memory repository. It's like things that have happened or will happen from Earth and from another place. Wherever that moon came from, it has memory from that place. That moon is a celestial thing. And I mean, it's the things that are there are super abnormal. I mean, it's celestial, I mean, from God. The things that are happening there, that's what I don't recommend that anyone try to go and build a base or something. They're gonna see bad stuff happening to them because that's a sacred place. That moon, it was placed there for sentient life on Earth specifically. Anyway, let's go back to this deal. See the pine cone deal, look. Maybe the Anunnaki, when they came to Earth, they in the Sumerian tablets say that they had to slow down around the moon to be a gravity assist to slow down because they were coming too fast. They didn't have the anti-gravity knowledge. They might have it now, and they have, you know, these people are long travelers. We know they've been here. This is their legacy. It's been found everywhere. And we know in the translation that Sitchin D were correct in many ways. I don't know why these guys, then they say that it's not true, that several people have translated the stuff and it's all right. Well, anyway, you see this bright spot on the sky on this picture of the universe. Well, those are fingers and fingernails. See, look at that. What do you think that is? You think a star will look like that, like a finger? And that's a fingernail, and that's another one. And then you find it's five of them, exactly like a hand. Really? You think? See, look at this picture. I mean, come on, man, you got to be stupid not to realize those are fingers. Those are hands. Look, five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many fingers are in a hand? 5. Where's the fingernail place in the hand, at the tip of the finger. What do you see here? Exact same thing. Look, they're all fingers. Look at that. Look at that, man. If I am not correct, how the hell this shit matches what I'm saying? See, there is a problem with people believing anything. They say, oh, UFO, yeah, oh, that is correct, right? An alien, that is correct. But if you show this is a celestial deal, no. Oh, that cannot be. No, that ain't right, no. Well, you tell me what kind of fucking shape is this right here. What do you see? A 2 deal with a brass pad at the tip. Which is what? A freaking finger. Look at the other one like that. Then look at the other one like that, curl. And another one. And when you realize there's 5 of them. Really? How many fingers are in a hand? And where the fingernail is placed? At the tip of the freaking finger. But no, there will be, look, if you look at any part of this picture, it's all like that. All of it. Not a single one is different. None. Look at that. What is that right there? A finger with a fingernail, the tip, and it's both. It's one on the end and one on the other end, because that's how it is. It's every single part of this is like that. Every celestial image you find is gonna be the same exact thing. Look, right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that. Always the hand is like that, holding something. And that Sumerian carving is like that too. It's holding the pine cone, the knowledge, the spirituality. Look at this picture in any part, and you will find that even when you make a panoramic view, you will see that it creates hands every which way. No matter what, it creates the same thing. That's the fabric of this reality. It's based on that shape. And it's trillions and trillions and trillions of times. Look, the pine cone, God, star, fire. Well, the pine cone is the pineal gland is where the knowledge is based, the spirituality, the consciousness, the highest consciousness, and it secretes the most at night. So that's why these were night gods, because the night is when that thing enhances. That's when we sleep at night, except if you're working during the day, during the night, and you have to sleep during the day, it's not the same. So check this out. I'm gonna show you now the picture I found in this dude posted. I look it up in the Apollo 17 image magazine. It's gonna freak you out, man. Look at this. That's the picture, and it's all messed up. But look what it's showing right there. It's 2 hands holding a dark deal that looked like a pine cone. It is a pine cone. Now I wonder if the Anunnaki saw that and they represented that on Earth in the carvings and stuff, because they commissioned people, humans, to do that. I said they didn't want them to carve their faces and what they look like, because they didn't look that human. Then again, we don't really know. They say that the reptilian looking dudes, well, I don't know, I wasn't there. There are some deals that show that. Anyway, look at this deal right here. Look at this. This is a no one hand, but there's several hands. Look at that. There's one on this side, one on the other. And then there is a hand on the top receiving that. It's not a tug of war. Let me show you what I had it wrong the first time. I thought it was only those hands like that. It's a hand like this. But then there is this hand right here grabbing it. So this is like, this is giving it and this is receiving it. This is like receiving it and this is giving it from above. See, look where the rim ends, where this hand begins. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a hand like that. And then look, this is a hand right here, like this. And there's another hand like this, but there is another hand over here, more translucent. Because the picture has been messed up to death. It's just like I say, nobody's looking into none of this. They don't think, they don't do, they don't analyze, they don't see shit. It's sad. Well, alien city, and there ain't no alien city anywhere in the moon. It's all carving, it's all sculptures that from far away look like it. Look, what's this? Another freaking hand, look at that. The thumb, look at that. Then you see the fingers right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then there is another hand here going downward, look, like that. Then this tube ends in another hand going down, look, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the thumb, 5. Look at that, right there. You see what I'm saying? This is, none of this is coincidence, and none of this is made up by me. It's there. It's just people, like I said, they don't see, analyze, or they don't, nothing. They don't think, and they don't realize. They don't read on top of that. That shit about the Sumerians and the Mayans, all of them are tied together by a common theme, which is knowledge. Those Sumerians were in Sumeria, which is Iraq. They spread around, they fought each other. The Enki song fought the Enlil songs for control, or stupid idiots. And they end up nuking each other. 7 nuclear weapons were thrown. One of them, each one of them had a horrible name. One of them was like the one that is smitten your soul before you even touched the ground. O sea, he killed you before you even knew it. Names like that, imagine. So in one of those, they end up having to leave because the nuclear fallout blew with the wind against the people that threw it at the other people, so they end up having to get the fuck out of there because the shit showered themselves. And the dude that came to, how they call them, the Mayans called him, Shivaja, no, what was his name? The dude that came, the serpent god, they came to, then they say he was a white dude with beard and he was blue eyes and was very tall and came from the ocean. So when the Spanish came to Mexico, they thought that those were the same dudes. They were not. Hundreds of years later, or thousands, who knows, they realized that these people were too late. The Spokers came to destroy and ransack their gold and everything else. Well, imagine, those conquistadors, they murdered a lot of people. They killed everyone in the Caribbean Sea. All those islands, they're blacks now, all slaves brought in by the same Spanish, because the indigenous people were massacred by them. They didn't want to become slaves, so they fought and lost. They were vanquished. Same thing in South America and North America. The only thing is that North America is huge.